Mr. Robinson, I want to ask you some questions and talk about, you know, what your life is like here in the jail and about your life itself. I want your permission to videotape this, knowing full well that the videotape and any questions I ask you and any answers that you might give would be printed in a newspaper article and also be seen on social media, for instance, Facebook or on a website. Do you agree to allow yourself to be videotaped and to use your words and answers?
Yes.
Okay. So, it's been a few days since I last saw you. I went to court with you where you were being arraigned. Was that your arraignment? Or the charges against you?
It was where I entered my plea.
You entered your plea?
Yeah.
And at that time, you were charged with burglary?
Yes, sir.
And
that's it.
Just burglary. Since then, you were brought back to the jail. And you want to talk about what happened when you came back? The incident?
I got into a fight.
What caused the fight?
It's just, you know, when you're in jail, you know, right now I'm the biggest dude in the pod, and the way it is, you know, people start crap with the biggest dude. You know, they feel like they gotta, you know, target the biggest dude and get into a fight with the biggest dude, and, you know, beat up the biggest dude, you're badass or whatever.
So it's all about who has power in the pod?
Pretty much. And, you know, some people, you know, are institutionalized and feel that that's the way it has to be, and that's not the case. I mean, it doesn't have to be like that. You know, I don't try to, you know, run nothing. I don't try to be an asshole to anybody, you know. He's the only person that I had a problem with, and, you know, it's kind of bullshit.
So you got in a fight, and now you're in isolation.
Yeah.
That's 23 hours a day in a cell by yourself. No contact with anyone, no windows, except the only people that talk to you are the guards.
Well, not necessarily.
Okay. Tell me what isolation's like. You get 1 hour a day out of your cell, right?
Well, yeah, I was in the holding cells up here, which is basically how you described it. Now I'm in a pod where my cell's locked. I can still see everybody else in my pod, but, you know, it's locked down 23 hours a day, and it really does suck, you know.
What sucks about it? Tell me, with 23 hours a day, you can't leave that cell, and you're in there by yourself.
Yeah.
How does Mr. Robinson spend 23 hours a day?
Mainly, I do a lot of coloring. It sounds childish. I thought we talked about it before, but I color pictures for my kids, and that way I can, you know, have some kind of something to give my kids, you know.
Mm-hmm. How many kids do you have?
I have two.
Two? How old are they?
Eight and two.
Eight and two. Have they been to see you since you've been incarcerated? Would you allow them to come and see you? Do you want them to come?
Yeah, I want them to come. They haven't been here. Hopefully I'll get to see them next week.
23 hours a day in isolation. How much do you sleep a day?
I don't really sleep very much.
Sleeping a problem?
Yeah. I have medical issues, and I don't really get much sleep. And I take medication that doesn't really allow me to sleep.
So. What kind of medical issues do you want to talk about?
Just psychological issues.
Okay.
Depression and anxiety and stuff like that.
So you take antidepressants? And anti-anxiety medication?
Yeah.
Are you on medication now?
Yeah.
How long have you been on this medication?
Since October.
Were you on medication before? In the years before?
No.
Is this the first time you started doing medication?
Yeah.
Legal medication?
Yeah. Legal medication.
Now, eventually you'll get sentenced. You'll go back and get sentenced. And we're not going to go into the any kind of legal details, but perhaps a plea deal's been worked out. Mm-hmm. You know you're going to do some time in the state penitentiary.
Yes.
Have you been there before?
No, I haven't.
You know what? You've been in the system many times.
Yeah.
You know what's waiting for you in the state pen. Talk to me a little bit about that. What anxiety about that, certainly, going there?
Not really. I already know what to expect, I'm just ready to get my time done. I want to get it over with, that way I can get back home with my family.
Okay. Are there other charges pending, other jurisdictions that you have to deal with?
I got a theft charge in another county, but I'm taking a plea deal to run it concurrent with this case, so it'll be the same amount of time.
Did you graduate from high school?
No.
When did you drop out?
In eighth grade.
When was the first time you were arrested?
I was 19.
You were 19? Was that a theft or burglary charge?
Yeah, it was burglary.
Why?
I was doing drugs and burglarizing businesses to get money to buy more drugs.
So you were stealing to feed your habit?
Yeah.
Was it meth?
Yeah.
When's the first time you smoked meth?
When I was 14.
14? Why? Friends doing it? I mean, what?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. What do you think of meth?
I'm not gonna criticize it or nothing, because a lot of people blame their problems in life on drugs or the way that they live life, but it's life choices that put me where I'm at, and it's not the drug's fault, it's my fault,
Yeah.
But I don't condone it, I'm not trying to, make it look like it, my life would be any better without it, or with it, probably never made the best choices while I was high, and probably would have chose a lot better paths if I wasn't high, but.
You get pretty aggressive when you're high? Does it change you?
Yeah.
Change who Mr. Robinson is when you're high?
Yeah,
you become
much,
a different person?
Pretty much, most of the time. My anger has a lot shorter fuse, if you want to put it that way.
Where do you go from here?
Just gotta, put my family before my habit. That was always my problem. I put my habit before everything else in my life.
Got a long road ahead of you.
Yeah.
You think you can turn things around?
Yeah, I do.
I'd like to come back sometime, maybe even a few years down the road, visit with you again, see how you're doing.
Okay.
Yeah. You need to stay out of trouble.
Uh-huh. Well, I went a long time not getting in trouble, It's just periods of my life I don't let the drugs take hold of me again, and know, it goes from good to bad real quick.
Thanks for taking the time to visit with me. I appreciate it.
Not a problem.
And good luck to you.
Thank you.